Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to thank you for being here today for this monumental occasion. This will be the greatest grappling event in 123 It's the Podcast history. The match will be held at Livingston Palace next Wednesday, October 11th at 4:45 p.m. The match is for the inaugural 123 It's the Podcast Heavyweight Championship. There will be no punching, no kicking, no knees, elbows, poking, fish hooks, eye gouging, or ball grabbing. Victory is by tap out, pass out, or points. There will be 5 1-minute-and-a-half rounds. If there is no submission after 5 rounds, the victory will be decided by points. We would like to thank Aspire Theater, Full Moon Rising Bakery, our not sponsors, Monster Rockstar Energy and Seneca Cigarettes. I'd like to thank Cosmo for being here. And I'd love to thank our lovely ring girls for bringing energy and grace to the room. Without any further ado, allow me to introduce my boy, the color commentator, John Bunce.
What's up, everybody? Thanks for coming out. Once again, let's thank Full Moon Rising for bringing us a box of dicks. We were very enjoyable. A fight like this only happens once every few months or so, but I don't have to hype this one. A pimpy titan versus a proud prince. The details are irrelevant, but we are in for one hell of a barn burner. And now, a short video introduction of competitor number one.
Basically what's going on is Zeke has been going around unchecked for too long. His tyranny has been ruling over way too many people and it's got to come to an end. Yeah. I have the power to do this. I'm doing this for you people. I will be the people's champ. 123 The Podcast needs a champion with a heart. Zeke doesn't have the heart to beat me. He can't do it. It's not beating in his chest. His favorite character on Game of Thrones is Ramsay Bolton. He's a bad guy. And I'm done with him and he's getting put in his place. He's gone on unchecked for too long and I'm the one to check it. That's what's going to happen. It's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, stepping up a weight class for this epic battle, I give you the Prince of Jamestown, the bravest man since Jon Snow, alias 10, alias JP, alias Lizard Man. Ladies and gentlemen, the pride of the cellar, Joe!
I'm coming home with it. He's done. He's finished. It's over.
And now, a video introducing challenger number two.
When the sun rises in the west and settles in the east, when the mountains crumble to the sea, that is the only time that you will ever taste victory from me. Joel Peterson, you think this is a game? You've been playing too long, boy. When you come one-on-one with the Seeker Taker, you will not only meet defeat, you will rest in. If you hold the butterfly in your hand and you release it, it comes back to you, then it is truly yours. But if it doesn't, it never was. Come October 11th, I'll have you in my little glass jar, butterfly boy.
Thank you.
called the Palace of Livingston. That's my place. That's my town. Livingston's my hood.
I can't keep cool. What did you say, boy? Princes and palaces, get your words right. There's only one thing that happens. October 11th, you shall rest in. Hold on, my phone's vibrating.
October 11th, worst day of your life.
Rest in peace.
All right, we're gonna open the floor up to questions now. Cosmo?
Hi, Cosmo Truth for 3TD News. My first question is for you, Joel. And then I'm gonna have the same question for you, Z. Joel, what is your take on the epidemic occurring on the streets of Jamestown, known as the solicitation of bootleg pickles and beef jerky?
I'll tell you one thing, he can't win. There's no way he's the champ of nothing. I'm the people's champ, and I'm gonna be the champ of this podcast. It's over for him. It's over, Z, you know it.
So,
that's all I gotta say on it.
Okay, well then, you Mr. Watruk?
Well, my opponent dodges the question, because all they can do is bark his pre-remembered lines. I have a strong stance on bootleg pickles and beef jerky. Some businesses may frown upon such things from small town farmers, but I truly appreciate a good pickle and a spicy jerky.
Everybody loves jerky. You can't be saying that I don't love jerky. Everybody loves that.
Well, you should have answered the question then.
Everybody knows I love jerky.
Oh, even if it's black market jerky? Answer the question! You ain't no jerky fan, pickle boy.
All right, Tim, hope you have a better question than Cosmo.
Tim O'Brien for 123 ITP Reporting Squad. Joel, when did this beef between you two start? And what specifically happened to take to this point?
Well, it basically started when I started noticing that Zeke rocks around unchecked. He's got no respect for anybody. He's always trying to get rides, even if he knows it's a little bit out of the way. He's leaking podcast information. He's leaking Game of Thrones information on the podcast or to his friends. Like, he says we're his friends, but he leaks that information to us. It's terrible. He's just walking around. He's got a bad attitude. He needs to get eaten. Ramsay Bolton's his favorite character. It's terrible.
Seek your response.
I am terrible. And I am sorry. But I will not hold back come October 11th.
I hope not. It's time to end the tyranny.
You crossed the line, boy.
That's the worst day of your life. We're going to march and I'll bring this title home with me.
You're going to pay.
This is for me.
You enjoy it. It's bad omen to touch the belt before a match.
I'm not scared of no omen. I'm not scared of no Z.
Oh, you will be. You will be.
Cosmo?
Yeah, well, I guess I just want to touch on that then. Zeke, do you think it is fair to disguise potential plot leaks as theories as far as popular TV series are concerned?
Your mother. That is all.
Can't answer the question. Not the people's champ. I'm the people's champ.
Okay, I got a follow-up question for that response. Is it true that we share the same mother?
Once again, Mr. Witruk, I will respond with your mother.
Okay, well, one more quick follow-up question. What is with the goofy outfit and that ridiculous voice you are poorly attempting?
My dog kicked me in the throat and I lost a bet. I had to wear this on camera.
Okay, thank you.
Tim, my man.
Another question for Joel. If you become the heavyweight champion, will you stay in this division?
Just to be clear, 123 ITP Grappling has three weight classes. Middleweight, heavyweight, and them tiny guys. Joel is moving up from middleweight, but is brave enough to make the jump.
You might be brave, boy. It's gonna take more than bravery come October 11th at the Livingston Palace.
My response to that is I'll take on anyone who is running around acting like Zeke, acting unchecked. Anybody that needs to get beat for good and for the people, I'm fighting for you. I got you. So I don't care if it's a middle class or even a tiny guy. I don't care if Paul's talking shit, I'll take down anyone.
JP!
I'm watching you, Kaz. You're next on the list.
You better win the fight then.
I will. I don't lose. I walk around unchecked.
Zen.
God, huh?
Yeah, you know, I was gonna say if you win, Joel, but when you win, where will you go and what will you do to celebrate?
You know, it's funny you should say that. I'll probably head over to Erie and go to Chick-fil-A. It seems like a fun place to...
It is. It's fantastic.
I mean, after a good friend of mine said that it was really good and that we would go there if it was open, and I'm sure it'll be open, so that's probably win, lose, or draw.
Fantastic. I guess, Zeke, same question for you. If you happen to pull off this victory, where will you go and what will you do to celebrate?
There are many things the dead man does to celebrate. But if we're talking pizza meter and full joy of the gourmet pizza variety, I too would have to agree with my nemesis. There is nothing better than the Chick-fil-A that is right there in Erie, Pennsylvania.
Not even a good buffet or a good steak?
You know, sometimes you add up with the steak and the potatoes
and the veggies
and the corn. Well, you know, you get salad, brings it back down, raw bacon. But there ain't nothing like Chick-fil-A, son.
Yeah, Chick-fil-A is good. We agree on that, that's for sure.
Tiny Tim, hit me with your best shot.
All right, one last question for Joel. Regardless of the outcome, will the beef be squashed?
There's no way to know, you know? I mean, I once saw Zeke take my good friend Jake Mescal on a fish hook and drag him across the room, and I haven't even responded to that, so I mean, I gotta beat this guy down and beat him within an inch of his life, and I don't think it'll be very tough for me to do. I bet you I do it inside of 2 minutes. That's right, the fight's over in 2 minutes, and I'm gonna be champion. So we, you know, we'll deal with that when that's over, Tim. That's a stupid question.
Same question to you, Mr. Taker.
Well, I do regret fish hooking Jake Mescal. He is a good soul. Sometimes later wrestling gets out of hand. But what I'm not sorry for is that his mouth was injured to the extent that he could no longer suck on Joel's dick for the rest of the weekend.
Yeah, that's right, motherfucker.
Don't you talk about Jake Mescal like
that. I said it. The whole weekend his mouth was too bloody for that shit. You couldn't take it. That's what this is all about.
And that's that, Tim. I like you. You're a good reporter.
The other one, whoever you are, what's your last question?
All right, so Joel, I think everybody in here and everybody in the world would like to know, will you be wearing tight spandex for this event?
It doesn't matter what I'm wearing. I'm gonna beat him up and down the place. It doesn't matter at all. He's dressed like Zorro. I'm gonna whoop his ass all over the place.
Please answer the question.
I could be wearing a Batman suit. I could be dressed like Big Bird. I could be wearing one of these dresses. I might be out there naked. I might be wearing flip-flops. He'd be the first guy to get his ass kicked by me wearing flip-flops.
That would be, I think we would all like to see that. So yeah, I'm really excited right now. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, that's pretty.
That's all I have for questions. Thank you.
All right, well that's it for questions, guys. Let's face these guys off and we're gonna see everybody next week at 4:45.
You can't win. There's no way. It's over for you, Zeke. It's time to get checked. You can't do this. I'm the champ. You can't be a champion. There's no way.
Listen, boy. When that box opens up, the sun will set in the west and rise in the east, and you will know the Zeke Taker has been here.
You're no champ!
My dragon mouth?
I don't have to be a champ. No. You comb yourself. Comb your tits, boy. Dip your balls in some cold water.
I'm not gonna do that.
All right, thanks, man.